niba vugire me by'uburezi ugiye uhita wumva Happy Kids School. Happy Kids School ifite abarimu b'inzobere batanga amasomo mu cyiciro cy'amashuri y'incuke ariyo nursery school cyangwa se gardienne tutibagiwe na creche ndetse n'amashuri abanza ariyo primary school. Mu cyiciro cy'amashuri y'incuke ariyo nursery school cyangwa se gardienne tubafitiye amashuri yose uko ratatariyo baby class, middle class na top class. Mu mashuri abanza cyangwa se primary school tubafitiye kuva mu mwaka wa mbere kugeza mu mwaka wa gatandatu. Nuza n'umwana wawe muri Happy Kids School uza muzanye amaboko meza by'abarezi b'inzobere muri uyu mwuga. Iri shuri riherereye hani gahanga iruhande rw'isoko ukase ku muhanda werekeza kuri cricket neza neza imbere y'urusengero rwa DP. Kushaka ibindi bisobanuro wahamagara kuri izi nimero zikurikira: 0788 63 86 83 cyangwa 0788 45 96 32. Zana umwana wawe ku ishuri ry'icyerekezo cy'ikinyagihumbi.
Yeah, good morning, dear children of P3. How are you? I hope you are finding there at home and you are protecting yourselves against this coronavirus pandemic. So, I'm Gilbert Musabiyukato, you know me. I'm your English teacher here at Happy Kids School. Now, this is the time for helping you to revise different activities we are given as part of holiday package. Are you ready? So take your pens, take your notebooks, and take your holiday package, and then get ready to work on me. Okay? So I hope everyone is ready. So now let us start. Today we are going to start with plural form of nouns. So I think you remember this because I even taught you about this before you went for your holiday package, before you went for your holidays. Now, so, when we talk about plural form, of nouns, we mean how to express more than one thing. Remember, sometimes when we are talking, we can express one thing, or we can express more than one. So, plural refers to more than one. So, let me give you a good example here. Here I have different papers. How many papers do I have? Can you see? There are two. So, these papers are many. So, we can say papers because there are two. But when I take this, then it can be a paper. It is one. You see the difference? So, now, the plural form of nouns means how we can use different nouns to mean more than one thing. So, the general rule, remember, singular is when we express one thing. We add S to make the plural. So this means that many English words take S in plural. For example, let me give you an example. A desk. et pensant. Can you see? These words are in singular. Singular means when we express one thing. So we are going to give them a plural form, which means that we are going to change them into plural. To mean more than one. So here I have a pen. As you can see here, the general rule says that we add S to many of English words. So a pen, we will say pens. You see, a desk, we will say desks. A pencil, we will say pencils. Why are we adding here S and not having here where we are expressing one thing? It's because the general rule in English says that many English words take S in plural. Do you understand? Okay, good. But this is not the only rule we have in English about plural. Let us see other rules we follow when we are expressing more than one thing. Okay? So, okay.
Okay, let us see rule three.
A, Y preceded by a consonant, T-I-E-S in plural. Okay, so I think it's clear. Nouns ending in Y preceded by a consonant, T-I-E-S. Preceded means when a consonant comes before Y. So let me give you some examples. Can you see here on the chalkboard? I have two words. One is a family. The second one is a city. So these words end with Y. And which letter is before Y, if you can see? Before Y here we have L. And here we have letter T. So L is a consonant. So when a consonant comes before Y, then we change Y into I and we add ES. So if we change this word in plural, then we will write fa, family. Then the Y is changed into I, then we add ES. Good. Can you see? It's simple. Now here we have a city. Y is at the end, and before Y there is a consonant. So when there is a consonant, remember in plural, we change Y into I, we change Y into I, and we add E, S, and we say cities. So here it's where in plural, it's where we express more than one thing. Okay, good. So let us go to rule number four.
Which requires you to put the words in.
in pro. Go to the paper 26. 26. And work on question B. Fill in the blank space with the correct form of the words in brackets. The first question says, they, da-da-da, are wearing hats. The word which is in bracket is God. God. So if you can see well, they are asking us to put this word in plural because the subject of the sentence is they. Remember, when the subject is they, then we are talking about more than one person or more than one thing. So you will change this word into girls. Then you will say, the girls are wearing hats. Okay. The question two says, the hen laid three in 1 week. Then they have given you the word egg. So, the hen laid three in 1 week. How many eggs are they talking about? They are talking about three eggs. Remember, when we are talking about more than one, then the word should have plural form. So we are going to put these eggs, egg in plural. So egg is among the words which take s in plural. So we say the ten red many eggs. Then we put s at the end. Okay? Number three. My uncle sells in his shop. In the bracket you have watch. Okay, so my uncle says, we will put this word in plural because he doesn't say one watch. He says many watches. So as you know, for what ending with C-H, they take E-S. So we say my uncle says, then we change the word, that word into watches. Like this, because this word ends with C H. Then number four. My mother keeps many in her kitchen. In the bracket you have knife. My mother keeps many in her kitchen. Then you are required to use the correct form of this word in the empty space. So, as we are talking about many, then you have to change this knife into plural. So, remember we have seen that for words ending with F or F with E, they take V, E, S. But we add V-E-S after removing the ending letter, which is F. So we will change knife into knives. So then we will say, my mother keeps many knives in her kitchen. So we are on question number five. The farmer harvested last week. You have the word potato. So you are required to give the plural form of this word. The farmer harvested potato last week. Remember, we have seen that for words ending with O, S, double S, C H, they take E S in plural. So you will change this potato into potatoes. Potatoes. So, do we add ES because this word ends with E? Ends with O. Okay. He broke. He broke grass. So here they're asking you to use the right form of this word given in brackets. So you will change this word into plural form. And because this word ends with S, you will say he broke glasses. Like this. Because you are adding ES because the word ends with double S. So remember, for words ending with double S, the rule says that we add ES to make its plural form. Okay, thank you very much.